12 noon, St. Clair's Attend Church Hall. Additional comfort is always needed. The faith formation program from St. Teresa Calcutta Parish will begin this weekend of October the 4th. Please see the bulletin. There are times, places, additional information, and procedures. Please be sure your cell phones and any other electronic devices are turned off this time. Then
of might and power, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
God of healing and compassion, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
God of wisdom, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth is He, O Lord, who will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, to take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us, to take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. Who are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you are the Lord of the Holy One, you are the Lord of the Lord, you are the Lord of the Lord, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law, upon the love of you and of our labor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the Trinity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let him turn to the Lord in mercy, to our God in prayer.
the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable: the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers to his vineyard. After agreeing with them with the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off, and he went out again around noon, and around 3 o'clock, and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why did you stand here alone all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his workmen, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to the one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. If you don't agree with me for the usual daily wage, take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous?" Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord. I have my usual joke. One summer, the bishop needed to hire a new gardener. The bishop's administrator had a friend named Mohammed, who was an excellent gardener. But there was one problem. Mohammed was a Muslim, and the bishop only wanted a Catholic gardener. The administrator said to his friend Mohammed, "Look, all you have to do is say why you are a Catholic, because the bishop always has the same the lawnmower, and the bishop is rather to ask his normal three questions. Who is the mother of Jesus? Mohammed looked down at the lawnmower and answered, Mary. He then asked, who is the adoptive father of Jesus? Mohammed looked down at the lawnmower again and said, Joseph. How did Jesus die? The bishop asked. Again, Mohammed looked down at the lawnmower and answered, on the cross. After Mohammed answered all the questions correctly, the bishop was suspicious. So he asked eight more questions. What were the names the two thieves who were hanged next to Jesus? Mohammed looked down at the lawnmower and answered, Black and Decker? In today's community, I would like to reflect on three points of the gospel. First, we are all invited to the vineyard of Jesus. Jesus calls all kinds of people to his vineyard. I myself have heard testimonies of the appearance of Jesus to Jewish people, to Muslims, even to agnostic people. God calls all of us, and he wants us all to reach salvation. Second, God gives equally to all of us and bestows his grace on each one of us. Even though some people seem to receive more than others, in reality, we all receive enough grace to reach heaven. Third, the following passage, my friend, I am not sheep. If you do not agree with me for the usual living way, take what is yours with God. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or can I agree with you as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Never complain to God about what graces or opportunities others before have received that you have not. To the best of your ability, use all the talents and graces that God has given you. Remember that the most important things, the end goal for all of us, is to reach salvation. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, help us all to be happy with the talents that you have given us. Help us to use all that you have given us to attain salvation. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This weekend we celebrate Catholic Father Sunday. It is the day we recognize the commission and bless those who will serve as Catholics through the coming year. In our preparation programs, youth group, children's liturgy, and RCIA. And I think by God's word and the teachings of the Church, such catechism impart to ours a deeper formation in the faith which they themselves have learned as true, to be lived and celebrated. command God's blessing on this catechism and all of us here today who also serve as catechists by sharing our faith with others. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We will lift up the Lord with the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right in us.
It is truly right and just unto me and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to you, boundless glory, that you came to the of mortal being with divinity and even passion for us and remedy out of mortality himself, that the cause of our power might be caused the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, beyond the terrors, in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave thanks to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from me, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." Sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection,
your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face, and mention us all, we pray, that may the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have placed your true obligations, remember it, to be for them to eternal life. And may it praise and glorify you through his Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor be yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Have a safe is coming. Gracious, grant her peace and unity in all those who will, for him.
masterful.